Ghana, one of the biggest and fastest growing economies in Africa, has made significant progress in encouraging private sector growth. Supported by donor partner SECO, investment climate and access to finance teams of the World Bank Group have helped the government of Ghana develop a modern, secure transaction system. In late 2008, the Borrowers and Lenders Act was passed. This law aimed at improving standards of disclosure of information by borrowers and lenders and prohibiting certain credit practices, in addition to promoting a consistent credit enforcement framework.
Now, with the passage of this law, we are able to use both immovable and movable property. And we think that that has the scope for businesses to be able to access more credit.
The Act also led to the establishment of the first electronic collateral registry in sub-Saharan Africa, a significant milestone not only for Ghana, but for the region as a whole, which is still to a large extent lacking access to business credit.
This registry is of immense benefit to the commercial banks. With the help of the IFC, we've been able to roll out all these programs, and we expect better performance in the coming years.
In Ghana, lending to lesser-known clients, for a long time perceived as a risky activity, has increased since the start of the World Bank Group-supported reform initiative, particularly benefiting micro-borrowers and SMEs.
The introduction of the collateral registry has resulted in the bank increasing credits to SMEs. First quarter this year alone, our retail to SME portfolio was 18%. And so as we go through second, third, and fourth quarter, by the end of the year, it would have increased significantly.
As of June 2012, more than 5,000 SMEs and 22,000 micro-businesses have received loans secured with movable property granted by banks and non-bank financial institutions corresponding to more than $3 billion in financing. The reforms are also helping women expand their businesses and increase their economic power.
The introduction of a registry has helped in that we could take stocks, for example, we could take vehicles, for example, household assets, business equipment as security for loans. And this has gone a long way helping other women to come on board to take loans.
Constance Swanaker, artist and founder of the Accra-based SME, Accents in Art, in Ghana, is a good example. She started creating her pieces of art, mostly furniture or home accessories, for a little pocket money. Recently, she was able to access her first loan by pledging her machinery as collateral. Thanks to the loan, she expanded her business and hired more than 30 men and women from the local community. She is now able to meet the growing demand for her products.
A lot of SMEs are investing whatever money they have into a setup, into a startup business. So really, we don't really have any other collateral. And a lot of the banks previously would not give you any money because banks are looking for land papers. I have a lot of brand new machines. When I needed to expand and I applied for a bank loan of 20,000 Ghana Cedi, they agreed. And then I was given the loan of $15,000. That helped.
The reforms implemented with the help of the World Bank Group are based on a sustainable, replicable framework that combines local resources and international expertise, ensuring both rapid results and deeper systemic reforms. But it was also the strong engagement of all stakeholders that made the program a success. Today, Ghana is seen as a pioneer for other African countries that are keen on gaining similar reform momentum.
The Ghanaian example will help my country tremendously in implementing similar reforms. It helped me learn what steps my country needs to take in creating a best practice model for reforms, especially how to regulate business activities in the formal and informal sector of Burundi.
Yet, much still needs to be done. The World Bank Group is currently working with the government of Ghana to pass amendments to the Borrowers and Lenders Act to further train public and private stakeholders in the usage of the registry and communicate the implemented reforms within the country.